फ्रेंड्स, आई एम कर्नल प्रदीप पिंडियाला, प्रोफेसर ऑफ एनेस्थीजियोलॉजी एट आश्रम मेडिकल कॉलेज, एलुरु सिटी ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश, इंडिया. फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट ओबेसिटी, मोटापा, लॉ ऑफ अटैक. नाउ आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ टू रिड्यूस वेट. What are the methods? What are the benefits of weight reduction? Obesity is a medical condition in which excess body fat has accumulated to an extent that it may have a negative effect on your health. People are generally considered obese when their body mass index, also known as BMI, a measurement obtained by dividing a person's weight in kg by the square root of the person's height in meters. Now, if it is over 30 kg per square meters, the range is 25 to 30 kg per square meter is defined as overweight. And if it is more than 30 kg per square meters, you come into the category of obesity. Now, obesity is correlated with various diseases and various conditions, particularly serious cardiovascular diseases are directly connected to obesity and your overweight. Type 2 diabetes, diabetes mellitus is also related directly to you being obese or overweight. Certain type of cancer and osteoarthritis, joint pains, also are connected directly to your obesity. Now, high BMI, I did mention about BMI, body mass index, which is obtained by dividing your height in meter, weight in kg divided by height in meters square root. If it is more than 30 kg per square meter, you are considered to be obese. I did mention that high BMI is a marker of risk. Many risks is a marker of risk, but not proven to be direct cause for diseases caused by diet, physical activity, and environmental factors. A reciprocal link has been found between obesity and depression, that's for sure. With obesity, increasing risk of clinical depression are seen, and also depression leading to higher chances of you developing obesity. They are directly related, interlinked. You having being obese can have depression, and your depression itself per se can cause you gaining extra weight. Now, obesity has individual socio-economic and environmental causes, including diet, that's for sure. Physical activity, that's for sure. The more the sedentary lifestyles you have, more the chances of you being overweight or obese. Automation, more of sitting on the computer, everything automatic, methods of food making, every lifestyle has become automated now. Urbanization, more city dwellers do become obese. You do see that. Mental disorders also can cause it. Economic policies, endocrine disorders. If you have certain endocrine disorders, you may develop obesity. And exposure to endocrine disrupting chemicals. While a majority of obese individuals at any given time usually are seen attempting sincerely to lose weight. You must have seen all of these people try sincerely to keep on reducing weight. Sometimes they are successful also. Unfortunately, research shows that maintaining that weight loss is rarely permanent. That means obese people try sincerely by dieting, exercise, etc. to reduce weight. They do reduce weight by dieting, etc. But that is transient. They revert back to their obesity within no time. Exact reasons are not known. Why? The reasons of weight cycling, it's known as weight cycling, are not fully understood, but may include decreased energy expenditure combined with increased biological urge to eat during and after caloric restriction. More you restrict your calories, you have the severe urge to eat. So it's counterproductive. Now, more studies are definitely needed to determine if weight cycling and yo-yo dieting. Yo-yo dieting means just like yo-yo, goes and comes back. That means the weight disappears, reduces, and again reverts back to relapse, back to extra weight. That means obesity comes back after dieting. Contribute to maybe due to inflammation and disease risk in obese individuals. Now, what are the preventions of obesity? Obesity prevention requires a complex approach, including interventions at community, family, and individual levels. Changes to diet and exercising are the main treatments recommended. I repeat, changes in diet and exercising are definitely the treatment recommended. Diet quality can be improved by reducing the consumption of diet-dense foods. Reduce the consumption of diet-dense food. What are they? Those which have high fat and sugars. Please reduce high sugar intake and fat intake, and increase intake of dietary fiber. However, large-scale analysis have found an inverse relationship between energy density and energy costs of foods in developed nations. Now, I'll tell you, very interesting. Low-income populations are more likely to live in neighborhoods that are considered food deserts. If you are low-income category and live in an environment, place, in a colony, normally you live in a colony which could be called food deserts or food swamps. There is hardly any groceries shops around your neighborhood. So the chances of you getting extra diet and food to consume is also less, because in your neighborhood, because of you being of low income population, there are hardly any grocery shop where you can buy your extra food and start eating and munching. Medications can be used along with suitable diet to reduce appetite. There are certain drugs which can be used to decrease your appetite, and thus you will reduce your weight. And it reduces the fat absorption also. Those drugs, those are the medication that can be taken, though they have harmful effects also, but they are definitely works. They do work on most of the people to decrease weight by reducing their appetite to eat and decrease the fat absorption. If diet and exercise and medications are not effective at all, even after 6 months, 1 year of sincere efforts and consumption of medications used for decreasing weight and exercising, diet control All methods have tried, but still your weight, obesity remains static. Then what is to be done? You have to undergo a balloon. There is something called gastric balloon to be put, or surgery may be performed. We call it bariatric surgery to reduce stomach volume and length of the intestines, leading to feeling full earlier, or reduced ability to absorb nutrients from the food. I repeat, there are certain surgeries known as bariatric surgeries that reduce your stomach size, volume, or the length of your intestines, leading to you feeling full earlier, much earlier. By eating little food, you feel satisfied. You don't feel like eating more. You feel full, or you have reduced ability to absorb nutrients from your intestines and stomach. That causes drastic reduction of your weight. That is known as bariatric surgery. Hope I have made it very simple, very interesting. Have a wonderful day. More in my next lecture, medical lecture. Until then, goodbye. Take care. I'm Colonel Pradeep signing off for tonight. Bye-bye.